These are the two touch displays I'm going to talk about in this video. Analyzing the characteristics of those displays, I will show you the library I developed handling their graphics and touch features. In the video description, you will find a link to my GitHub page related to this library, all the test functions and the examples we will see here, and all the information needed to set up an STM32 project using these displays and this library. This display is a 2x4 inch size, and the resolution is 240 by 320 pixels, and it is driven by an ILI 9341. The touch sensor is handled by an XPT2046. So, the board has two SPI ports, the graphics port and the touch sensor one. We will see that the ILI graphics SPI port works up to 50 megabit per second, while the touch driver gives correct results communicating below 1 megabit per second. That's because the touch driver performs an analog to digital conversion while communicating. And anyway, the speed is not a problem handling the touch driver, because the communication is very short, transferring just few bytes. This display is a 3.5-inch size, having 320 by 480 pixels. Graphics is handled by an ILI 9048. While the touch driver is the same as the one of the other board, an XPT2046. Here also, ILI driver works over 50 megabit per second. You can find on the market many different boards for the 3.5 display. Here we have one marked as version 1.0 and one marked as version 2.0. I found absolutely no documentation describing the differences between the boards, but we will see that the differences are relevant and we will handle the two boards separately. Both displays are provided with a stylus, but as Steve Jobs said, we don't like stylus, so I prefer the 3.5-inch displays, allowing an easier finger interface, and only developing projects with some critical size and having an easy interface, I go using the 2x4 display. The two ILI drivers have a command format similar to the ST7735 commands I already described in another video. I mean, they are not the same, but the basic graphics command addressing the screen, defining the screen area to draw, sending pixel color to the display and so on, really have a similar structure. So it was quite easy adapting what I already did for the ST7735 to these drivers. I will not go here into details of the strategy used and the performance of the graphics function I developed. If you are interested in, you can see my video describing that about ST7735. I will leave a link in the description. I will show here a comparison of the characteristics and the performance of the two drivers, and then I'll describe the touch handling function I developed. ILI 9341 allows transferring pixels over SPI through two color formats, RGB 565 or RGB 666. RGB 666 provides a higher color depth, but the difference is not so much between the two formats. On the other hand, 565 needs 2 bytes per pixel on SPI, while RGB 666 needs 3 bytes, which is 50% more data and 50% more time to transfer. That's why I will use 565 format in my functions. ILI 9048 allows on SPI RGB 666 or RGB 111. As I said, RGB 666 needs 3 bytes per pixel, while RGB 111 needs 1 byte for 2 pixels, which is a really compact color format, but it is also really poor. 1 bit per color means we will have a total of 8 color palette available, including black and white. So the by-consuming RGB 666 is the only one color format available on ILI 9488. But Moving through the ILI data sheet, we can see there is a single point in the manual, just a single paragraph, a single sentence, referring to the availability of RGB 565 format on SPI. That is not anymore considered next in the document, and it seems to be something like a mistake, a misprint. But trying to force ILI 9488 using RGB 565, I've seen that boards version 2 were able to handle it, and only those boards. That is a big difference because, as we have seen, RGB 666 need on SPI 50% bytes more than 565. That means that graphics on version 1 boards will need a time 50% longer than what requested by the version 2, at the same SPI speed. This is a table comparing the data needs by the various display driver for a full frame, a clear screen command. The first display is the ST7735 we already seen, and I'm considering it here for a comparison with the other displays. The display size is 128x160 pixel with RGB 565 color format. That means a full frame needs 40 kilobytes. The 2x4 display having ILI 9341 needs 150 kilobytes for a full frame. The ILI 9488 version 2 needs 300 kilobytes, while the version 1 board needs 450 kilobytes. You can see that the differences are relevant, coming to relevant differences between the times needed for the SPI communication. Here is the timing to perform the drawing tests you can find in a library, and we already analyzed in the ST7735 video. The table shows the time needed by the three display, again compared with the small ST7735, working on three different STM32 microcontroller. The first one is an M411 used on the WIAC Studio Black Pill board running at 100 MHz. The second board is a Nucleo 64G071. And the third one is a Nucleo 32 G431. It runs up to 170 MHz, and its SPI can run up to 75 Mbps per second. That will let us to see the faster speed display SPI can handle. The table seems quite annoying, showing a lot of numbers, but analyzing them, we can find some interesting information. Let's analyze them separately. First of all, we have a confirm of the differences between the ILI 9488 board version 1 and version 2. Version 2 allows a data transfer much faster than version 1, due to the availability of the RGB 565 color format. And you can see that version 1 board needs a time about 50% longer than version 2. In the G431 test, I could verify for each display the fastest SPI speed handled. We can see that ILI 9488 version 1 and version 2 and also ST7735 works up to 55 Mbps per second, while I was able to run ILI 9341 up to 70 Mbps per second. I compare the times registered at the fastest SPI speed with the second test, run with a microcontroller at 170 MHz. With this clock, microcontroller can run SPI at 42.5 Mbps per second, and comparing the two working configurations, we can see that the clear screen test gives better results with a faster SPI speed, while in the other test, with a shorter dataset to transfer, the availability of a faster microcontroller gives better results even if the SPI port is lower. The last analysis can be done on different microcontrollers of the STM32 family. Comparing the F411 with the G431, we can see some interesting information. Consider that G4 and F4 share the same core, which is a Cortex-M4, but G4 microcontroller have enhanced features on both SPI and DMA devices. But that enhancement needs a larger time to start DMA-SPI transfer. So, if a dataset is short, we surprisingly have better time with a F4 slower microcontroller having also a slower SPI. That is what about the graphics display comparison. Now we will see the touch sensor and its driver. I tried to get over the internet the datasheet of this device. Manufacturer doesn't provide information on its website, and I could get this documentation only from other websites. As you can see, this document has a lot of errors, and sometimes is really ununderstandable. Its English is even worse than mine. But you can see also that the document structure, pictures, tables have more or less the same format as what reported on the Texas Instruments TSC2046 touch driver datasheet. Even the pictures are exactly the same. So it really seems that XPT2046 is a clone of the Texas Instruments touch controller. And I refer to that datasheet to get information. The device is an analog to digital converter that reads the resistance value of a touchscreen when it's pulled. When touched, the resistor value changes, allowing to detect the position of touch. The touchscreen provides the resistance value over three coordinates, X, Y, and Z. X and Y refers to the horizontal and vertical position of touch. Z refers to the strength of the touch. 2046 driver and the board also provides a pin reporting a digital on-off level indicating the screen is touched and can be used to drive an interrupt over the microcontroller. The first test function I made, available in the library you can get on GitHub, is a simple reading of the values returned by the driver showing the result over the display. You can see that while reading, returns a non-zero value even if the device is not touched, and when touched, it returns a lower value. That is not true for the ILINA3048 that, depending on touch position, the return value can be higher or lower than the untouched return value. Here you can see that sometimes X and Z also returns a non-zero value. The test function shows also the interrupt received on the touch pin. The pin level is low when there is a touch, so the interrupt was set on the falling edge detection. But you can see the interrupt is triggered sometimes even when releasing the touch. It seems like there is a bouncing of the sensor, and that has to be considered developing the software. About the calibration, the conversion from the touch values read to the display position, there is an interesting reading provided by Texas Instruments showing how to correctly develop it. Even if limiting analysis to a linear conversion from the touch device to the display, we have to consider the scaling factors, the orientation factors and the rotation, and that is solved through the algorithm proposed by the Texas Instruments documentation. In my calibration function, I use a simplified version of this algorithm, supposing there is no rotation between the two devices, else than a multiple of 90 degree rotation. That should be enough, considering that we will use fingers driving the display, so we don't need an extreme precision doing the conversion. Finally, there is a function testing the complete read and convert activity using touch. All the reading functions available in the library are activated by the display interrupt, so the whole touch reader handling have a low impact on the overall microcontroller performance. And now that I got a fast display software library and an efficient touch sensor handling, I can try to move to more complex graphics user interface applications like touch GFX that we will see in another video. Just one consideration about GPIO interrupts. If you are used to develop software on the G0 range of the STM32 microcontrollers, you already know that HAL library for these microcontrollers provide a GPIO interrupt callback function name that differs from all the other STM32s. While all the STM32 have a generic callback from the GPIO interrupt, G0 has two distinct interrupts for the rising edge interrupt and the falling edge one. In some communications, STM confirmed that G0 HAL has to join to the others in the next version, but at the moment G0 microcontroller needs a distinct callback function. That's the reason why you will see that double function name reference in the library. The whole library shown here for both graphic display and touch sensor is available on my GitHub page, link in the description, and GitHub has also all the details about using the library in a CubeIDE project. Thank you for watching this video. Hoping you enjoyed it, see you to the next one.